Peace and blessings is real. First and foremost, before we get into this word, let's acknowledge our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, through His only begotten Son, Yahushai. Without the Lord and His only begotten Son, man, ain't none of this happening. So we must give them their due. If you're alive today, man, you ought to thank the Lord. If you have your closest loved ones in your life, you ought to thank the Lord. If you have a good bill of health, you ought to thank the Lord, man. If you got food, shelter, transportation, your finances is allowing you to have your daily bread, you ought to thank the Lord, man. If you got a peace of mind, you ought to thank the Lord. If you have life itself, man, thank the Lord, man. It's just a beautiful time to be mindful, to thank the Lord of the situations and the things that you may have. And tonight's word, man, I hope you sincere brothers and sisters are truly edified by tonight's word. And we're going to name this word: if you have a wife, do not seek to end the marriage. If you have no wife, do not seek marriage. Let me say it again. The name of tonight's word is going to be called: if you have a wife, do not seek to end the marriage. If you have no wife, do not seek marriage. That's right, brothers and sisters. What we're going to talk about tonight is marriage versus singleness. Okay. And I'll give you a couple, you know, I'll give you a cheat code of this word tonight. Okay. Let's just say this. When you're a spiritual person and you married, man, you really got a tough ride. You know, marriage is a beautiful thing, but when you trying to live for the Lord and live your spiritual life, it's a hell of a task. It can be done, but you just know you're gonna have to put in some work, man. But when you're single and you're a spiritual person, man, your only focus is on the Lord. That's your only obligation. But when you marry, okay, you have to tend to that spouse. And it's on top of all the other things that you have to deal with in life. So in this word, man, we're gonna talk about marriage and singleness. And marriage, I'm always gonna be pro-marriage. To the day I die, man, it's all about marriage, okay? So it's not about you choosing which way you want to go. It's not about that. It's all about marriage, okay? It's always about marriage. You dig? If any of you sincere brothers and sisters are married, may the Lord allow y'all marriage to prosper. May the Lord allow y'all to overcome any issues that may hinder your marriage or cause any type of problems. May the Lord strengthen you guys and keep Satan up out of your business, man, and allow y'all to prosper. But in this word, we're going to come to you in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 27. And it reads, Paul is asking a question. It says, "Are thou bound unto a wife? Seek not to be loosed." And then the second question Paul answered was, or asked, "Are thou loosed from a wife? Seek not a wife." See that? So we're going to look at the two of those, okay? What did I say we're going to focus on in this word? Marriage and singleness. So the first part of 1 Corinthians 7 and 27 speaks about marriage. It says, "Are thou bound unto a wife?" In other words, are you put under obligation of marriage unto a wife? And if you are, it says, "Seek not to be loose. Seek not to be divorced. Seek not to be set free." See that? Why? Because marriage is a beautiful thing, man. And Yahushua told you, "Let no man put asunder what God put together." So marriage is everything, man. Even in Genesis 2 and 24, matter of fact, let me get that, which is the original institution of marriage, okay? The original institution of marriage. And it reads, it says, "Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. You see that? So marriage is a beautiful thing. You're going to have your highs, your lows, your in-betweens, okay? So you sincere brothers and sisters that are married, okay? It says, seek not to be divorced. Seek not to be set free. Make it work, man. You in it, make it work. It's a beautiful thing, okay? It also says, are thou loose from a wife? Are thou divorced and set free from a wife? Seek not a wife if that's the case. What, look at what you see on the screen. This is what it looks like, man, when you're going through a divorce. When you're headed for divorce, or is divorce like vibrations and vibes in your marriage? This is your first sign right here that y'all headed to divorce. Y'all not seeing eye to eye. Y'all seeing back to back. You see that? Y'all supposed to be seeing eye to eye. Y'all seeing back to back. There's no communication there. It's over. You know, Satan came in and made and caused division with y'all. You see? What you see on the screen is the prelude down the road of divorce. So when it says, are thou loose from a wife? So are you, if you divorced from your wife or set free, amen, seek not. Okay, be content to live without having a wife. Be content without being married, man. And I'm gonna tell you why. It don't mean to go out here and just start dating and doing whatever you want to do. No. That ain't what that is. Understand what Paul is saying here, first of all. In this particular time, y'all, you know why the question is being posed? If you have a wife, don't seek to end marriage. If you have no wife, do not seek marriage. Because right now, we in a dangerous time in the world. Okay? We got, you know, current distresses, current tribulations. It's a lot of madness going on in the world. The uncertainty of life. We in captivity. We in spiritual captivity. We're dealing with persecutions and afflictions, hardships. There's a lot of serious challenges living in today's world. So with that being said, if you are married, due to all of those things that's going on, Paul is saying, don't seek to end the marriage. You in it. Make the best of it. But just know, as you on your quest to serve the Lord, while you married, please understand all these distresses and tribulations that you're going to have to, that you're going to have to deal with. And then on the flip side, if you are loose from a wife, seek not a wife. Why? Because the current situation is at hand. So if you don't have a wife, at least now you know, you can pay attention and really focus on the Lord. That's why it says to you fellas out there, it says he that in 1 Corinthians 7:32, he that is unmarried careth for the things that belong to the Lord, how he may please the Lord. See that? So if you loosed from your wife, there's no need to get another one because your focus should be on the Lord anyway and how you please the Lord. But look what it says in verse 33 in 1 Corinthians 7. But he that is married careth for the things that are of the world, how he may please his wife. So it goes back to those that are bound unto a wife. If you have a wife, you don't seek to end the marriage. Why? Because we understand that marriage is a beautiful thing. And while you're married to that woman and with all the things that's going on in this world, you also going to be putting more of your energy into how you may please that woman. See, you can't please the Lord as much as you want because you have another obligation in front of you on top of all the current distresses and tribulations. You see? Cold-blooded, man. Yeah. So when you're a married man, hey, it's a beautiful thing. But at the same time, you know, as you serve the Lord, you also got to be mindful to please that woman. And at the same time, be mindful of all the distractions that the world brings. You see? So it's all about marriage in this word. I'm not encouraging no one to get divorced or not get married. The point is, if you are married, stay in that marriage, make the best of it, be mindful of what's going on in the world on top of you serving the Lord and keeping your marriage healthy. And then on the flip side, if you out of a marriage, don't seek to get in another one, man. Be content to live without that. Why? Because now you can focus and care for what the Lord may bring, and then you'll be able to navigate through a lot of the madness that's going on out here. Now, Paul even, you know, Paul was trying to show you that about these current, the reason why he posed the question the way he did, because he currently dealt with distresses and tribulations. And let me get that for you. And 1 Corinthians 15, verses 30 and 31, Paul said, "And why stand we in jeopardy every hour? I protest by your rejoicing, which I have in Yahushua, I die daily." You see that? So Paul was already dealing with tribulations and distresses. So his whole thing is like, damn, you know what I'm saying? Be mindful that, hey, you're going to go through it in this world, man. And if you got a wife, hey, make the best of that. But if your wife leave you or whatever the case may be, don't trip, man, because you already dealing with some funk out here, you know? So at the end of the day, man, if you have a wife, do not seek to end that marriage. Fight for that marriage. Do whatever necessary to keep that marriage, because ain't nothing better than that, man. Marriage is the best, you dig? It's such a beautiful thing. You know, the couple on the screen don't understand or value the beauty of marriage, man. But again, if you are under no matrimonial agreement or an engagement, then, hey, man, just focus on the Lord. And at the same time, man, keep your eyes open to deal with all this stuff that's going on in the world. And I'm going to keep it gangster with you. Okay. I'm not saying don't never get married again. What I'm saying is during this current madness, if you just so happen to not be married, it's not a big deal, bro. But Paul also said, though, to avoid fornication, he said it's not good for a man to touch a woman. But to avoid fornication, go get you a wife. That's 1 Corinthians 7 and 1. So if you're not married right now, that don't mean go out and date all these women, or women go out and date all these men. No. You are to focus on the Lord. And we're talking about spiritual people. You are to focus on the Lord. But if you have a burning desire where you got to get out here and have some affection when it comes to a man, if you're a woman, when it comes to a man, just go get you a husband. Then you legit, it lines right up with your spiritual walk. Go get you a husband, which is your own, and you all to the good. You don't go out and hook up with the next woman husband just for a cheap thrill. No. You ought to stay focused on Yahweh through his only begotten son, Yahushua. You see, it's all about, we're talking about marriage versus singleness. And singleness is not where it's at. It's all about marriage, man. Believe that. I hope you sincere brothers and sisters were truly edified by this word. And we give all praises, glory, and honor to our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, through his only begotten Son, Yahushua, for allowing his word to come out, man. Shalom.